It is a wonderful honor to be with you today. Very grateful to Bishop Mayer for his invitation. He's an old and dear friend from God's country, Lubbock. And it's a wonderful thing to be gathered with Episcopalians who are really glad they're Episcopalians. We preach our best sermons to ourselves. If I offend anybody with what I'm about to say, please remember that I'm talking to myself every bit as much as I'm talking to you. I want to begin with a question today. Do any of you really understand, I don't, why our nation is so riven with discord and antipathy bordering on hatred today? The reason civil wars are often so much more violent than other wars is that in civil wars, brothers kill brothers and sisters kill sisters. And those we kill often resemble us much, much more than those standing on the boundaries wondering what the fuss is about. So it was between the Jews and the Samaritans. They worshiped the same God, but they worship that God differently, and so they grew to despise each other. The situation at the time of Jesus was not altogether different from what we see in the Middle East today. It's not simply the conflict between the Israelis and the Palestinians, it's also the conflict between the Shia and the Sunni, Muslim versus Muslim. We often hate those most who most resemble us. Jesus was very, very conscious of the antipathy between Jews and Samaritans in his time. And yet, over and again, he and the Gospels present the Samaritans only in a positive light. Think about it. In the 17th chapter of Luke, Jesus and his disciples are passing from Samaria to Galilee, and they come across 10 lepers who plead, "Jesus, Master, have mercy on us." Jesus tells them to go show themselves to the priest. On the way, they're all healed of their leprosy, and Luke goes on to tell us that one of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back, praising God with a loud voice. And he prostrated himself at Jesus' feet and thanked him. Then Luke shocks us with this information. And he was a Samaritan. And of course, we all know the parable of the good, which of the three passers-by was willing to render aid to the man who had been beaten and robbed. Jesus knew exactly what he was doing. Every time he told a story in which he extolled a Samaritan, and every time he reached out his hand of fellowship to welcome into the kingdom a Samaritan, he was breaking all the categories and pushing the very hearts of his disciples to their limits. But he was also making a point. My kingdom is not of this world. He or she who does the will of my Father in heaven is a citizen of my kingdom. Now I want you to do something for me. Please bring to mind the group